ऐं ह्रीं श्रीं ऐं क्लीं सौः हंसशिवसोऽहं मत्प्रेम मत्क्षमरोह्यूं मतौं सक्षमरोहीं सहौः स्वरूपनिरूपणहेतवे तु गुरवे श्री अन्नपूर्णाम्बादयितं श्री अमृतानन्दनाथ सरस्वति श्री गुरुद्री पादुकां पूजयामि तर्पयामि नमः अगजान्न पद्मार्कं गजाननमहन्नितम् अनेकदन्तं भक्तानां एकदन्तोपास्मे गणानां त्वा गणपतिं गवामहे कविङ्गवीनाम् उपमत्रवस्तमम् ज्येष्ठराजं ब्रह्मणा ब्रह्मणस्पद आणशृण्वन्नूतिभिस्तेतसाधनम् ॐ श्रीमन्महागणाधिपतये नमः गुरुब्रह्मा गुरुविष्णु गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुस्साक्षात् परब्रह्म तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः ॐ श्रीं ह्रीं क्लीं क्लौं गं गणपतये वरवरदसरदनमेव तमानये स्वाहा ॐ श्रीं ह्रीं क्लीं क्लौं गं गणपतये वरवरदसरोजनमेव तमानये स्वाहा ॐ श्रीं ह्रीं क्लीं क्लौं गं गणपतये वरवरदसरोजनमेव तमानये स्वाहा ॐ श्रीं ह्रीं क्लीं क्लौं गं गणपतये वरवरदसरोजनमेव तमानये स्वाहा सूक्तम् इस् अ काम्बिनेशन् आफ् सिलेबस् विच् प्रोड्यूसेस् सम् गुड् एनर्जी एण्ड् ऐ नीड् टु टेल् यू ऐ डिण्ट् लर्न् Vedas, I didn't learn Smartham. My Guru told, it's more than Udatta Anudatta Swaras, I mean rising, the tone rising and then lowering. More than that, the correct pronunciation with understanding of the meaning gives more energy to us. I'm not saying this Swara is not at all important, but even if you cannot follow the swaram, because even if you go to some videos or audios on the internet, each person has got their own swaras. Anapagamini, somebody say. Anapagamini, somebody say. Tam mamavaha, tam maavaha. Let us not bother which is correct, which is not correct, because nobody can say which is correct and which is not correct. It's from the Veda, we need to go to the script and find out with his Udatta Anudatta. But for now, let's focus on the meaning and the correct pronunciation. And as far as possible, the Swara. Like I told you before, Jata Veda, Agni, the fire god, he is the mediator between us and the deity. Agni is actually not a form. When I say mediator, it's a Suddha Jnanam. Agni means Jnanam, knowledge. The knowledge is, the quality of that knowledge is, it absorbs everything, but doesn't keep anything in it. It just burns. Fire doesn't have anything. Whatever you give, it burns. That kind of knowledge we need to have. We learn and absorb. And we don't even know that we know that we know. Jataveda, why we say? Even though the verse says, Aspadaye Chagodaye Dhanadaye Mahadane, in the Phalasruti, it looks like give me cows, give me horses, give me money. It may look like that. That's why every prayer is a rahasya, uhya, goptri. That doesn't mean no one should recite, only certain section of the people should recite. You should have a diksha to recite. No one said. You need to get the help of a guru or a pandit to understand the inner meaning of the suktam so that you don't misunderstand the purpose of the suktam. Many people will think if you recite Sri Suktam on a Friday, you'll get money. You do puja with the Sri Suktam, you get money. But the real meaning, we are going to learn one by one. So, what you need to do, I'm going to recite this verse two or even three times. You recite at your end, trying to match with my pronunciation. Om Hiranyavarnam Harinim Suvarna Rajasastrajam. Om Hiranyavarnam Harinim Suvarna Rajasastrajam. Keep on saying along with me. After me, not along with me. After me, every time. Om Hiranyavarnam Harinim Suvarna Rajasastrajam. Chandram Hiranmayim Lakshmim Jataveto Mamavaha. Chandram Hiranmayim Lakshmim Jataveto Mamavaha. Some people say Ma'avaha. That's Patantram. Both are correct. Again. Om Hiranyavarnam Hiranyavarnam Harinim Suvarna Rajasastrajam. Chandram Hiranmayim Lakshmim Jataveto Ma'avaha. Om Hiranyavarnam Harinim Suvarna Rajasastrajam. Chandram Hiranmayim Lakshmim Jataveto Ma'avaha. What is the meaning of this line? You see two metals here. Hiranya or Suvarna Rajata. One is gold, one is silver. You're asking Jataveda. You're asking that fire of knowledge in us. You're actually kindling that fire. Hey, fire of knowledge in me, which is at the Ajna Chakra, wake up so that you can bring that auspicious Lakshmi to me. And how is that Lakshmi? Let us focus on the colors first. But behind the colors, there is a tattva that is more important. Hiranyavarnam Harinim. Golden aura, golden color. Harinim is also golden color. Why they use two words? There are three different meanings. Papa Harinim, the imagination, the visualization of the golden color removes the sins. That doesn't mean what all you have done will go away. It may go away also, who knows? But at least one thing is sure, you will not get any bad thoughts forever if you keep on imagining that golden aura. Bala Bhanu, Bala Arkoti Satyusam, the rising sun. That kind of golden aura you need to visualize when you say, Hiranyavarnam Harinim. What is that I'm going to get by visualizing that golden color? Because gold is connected to sun. And sun is connected to the life energy in us. That's why Harinim. Harinim is deer. And the deer is the most active animal. Smallest sound, it will react and run. That means I am agile. I am not agile to the external sounds. I am agile, but I am agile to the internal sound. That's why we start the mantra with deer, Murugi Mudra, thinking of the deer, so that that kind of power can come to my brain. Any small sound from this, I'll be alert. And that alertness is caused by sun, and that sun is activated by Hiranya, that gold color, and that gold color or that aura is compared to Lakshmi. Lakshmi is compared. So Hiranyavarnam Harinim Suvarna, again, Suvarna Rajatastrajam, and she is wearing garlands made up of Suvarna, gold, as well as silver. Now gold is connected to sun, we just told. Silver is connected to moon. So it's not enough if I just have the knowledge. I should have a control of mind so that my desires are limited. My ego is well controlled. So this is what is given by moon, which is activated by Rajata, silver. So when you think of the silver white color, you get the control of mind and lack of ego. At the same time, when you think of that golden color, you get that life energy and the perfect jnanam. That's why in Lalita Sahasranama also, Sindhura Aruna Vigraham, you start with Sindhura Aruna. And in Navavarna Puja, Ardram, Ardram Jwalati Jyotirahamasmi, Jyotirjwalati Brahmahamasmi, Yohamasmi Brahmahamasmi, Ahamasmi Brahmahamasmi, Ahamevahammam Juhomi Swaha, Ardram Jwalati. Ardram is wet. Jwalati means fire. How can these two happen? That means I need to have fire on my left side, wetness on my, fire on my right side, wetness on my left side. That means the knowledge, power, strength, confidence, the male qualities should be well controlled on the right side, compassion, love, and they should be unlimited, uncontrolled compassion. These two are together will give you to enjoy the Brahma Tattvam. Ardram Jwalati, once I know that these two qualities are in me, then I will be eligible to see the Brahma Tattvam in me, in around me. The same thing is Hiranyavarnam, Hiranyavarnam, Harinim, Suvarna Rajatastrajam. That Sra letter is very important. Sra denotes for knowledge, Ra denotes for flow, Chaitanya, Agni. So when you think of those colors, the knowledge should flow in you like fire, but at the same time, lack of ego, sattvika tattvam, universal compassion, and that should flow like a cool moonlight. One is bright sunlight, one is moonlight. These two are necessary. That's why he says, Chandram Hiranmayim Lakshmim Jataveto Maavaha. Hey, fire of knowledge, or knowledge in the form of fire, please bring that Lakshmi to me. Maavaha. For me, do the Avahana. Where Avahana? Inside me, not outside. Lakshmi is not coming from outside. Lakshmi is already inside. And let me know, let me have that power of knowing that Lakshmi in me. Not knowing Lakshmi inside is called Alakshmi. That's all. There is no Alakshmi separately. Not knowing that there is Lakshmi inside me or inside you is called Alakshmi. So, Chandram Hiranmayim Lakshmim Jataveto Maavaha. So, once again, that slokam. Om Hiranyavarnam Harinim Suvarna Rajatastrajam Chandram Hiranmayim Lakshmim Jataveto Maavaha Tam Maavaha Jataveto Lakshmim Anapagaminim Tam Maavaha Jataveto Lakshmim Anapagaminim Tam Maavaha Jataveto Lakshmi Manapagamini. Yasyam Hiranyam Vindeyam Gamaswam Purushanaham. Yasyam Hiranyam Vindeyam Gamaswam Purushanaham. Yasyam Hiranyam Vindeyam Gamaswam Purushanaham. Once again. Tam Maavaha Jataveto Lakshmi Manapagamini. Try to recite along with me now. Tam Maavaha Jataveto Lakshmi Manapagamini. Yasyam Hiranyam Vindeyam Gamaswam Purushanaham. Now, is saying, why I want this Lakshmi? Hey, Jataveda, Tam Maavah Jatavedo Lakshmi Manabhagaminim Yasyam Hiranyam Vindeyam Gamasvam Purushanaham. This is the main thing. Ga, Gavam is cows. Ashvam is horse. Purushanaham, Purusha is relatives, Bandhu. All these three are not, you should not take the literal meaning. What can you do? What can Shanil will do with the horses and cows in New Zealand? He's already a single person. What can I do? No. Give me that wherever the Lakshmi, hey Jataveda, bring me that Lakshmi with whose presence I have a purity like a cow. I have every kataksham vallaite naku govulanti pavitrata vostundo, ashvanlanti chaitanyam vostundo, with whose grace I will have the purity of like a cow. Because Hindus, we believe the purest soul we can think of, purest animal we can, purest jiva we can think of is cow. We worship ashva. It will never lie down. Even for sleeping, it will stand and sleep. If it lies down on the ground, that means sick or dead. So give me that kind of energy, that kind of power. That's why it's called energy is measured in horsepower. Right? So like horse, give me that power. With whose grace that power and purity come? And with whose grace the bandhus? Relative means not that kind of relative, uncle, aunt. No, 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 no. Everybody will have. Whether you recite Sri Suktam or not, each of you have got uncles and aunts. Right? They are not telling that. With these two qualities, one is Chaitanya, one is purity, I will win over the world like my family. The world becomes my relatives. Now you see how many relatives I have. Each part of the world, they are coming and looking at me, enjoying my presence. I am enjoying your presence. Is it not bandhu? It's more than that bandhu. It's called atma bandhu. That pulls you here. So this kind of asset, this is the asset. Not the, just the money. We should have money. We should have a house. But more than that, let us have the purity. Gamasvam purushanaham. And yasyam hiranyam, and hiranyam I missed, gold. Gold is the supreme metal. Now, of course, platinum they say, but for us in Hindu Dharma Shastra, gold. Like in metal, gold is supreme. Jivas, with her anugraha, I'll be the supreme in character. The gold is the only metal which can adore the necks of the gods, necks of the shaktis, you ladies in front of us. Nothing else. Of course, nowadays, all the metals they are wearing. But gold is the only one it is supposed to be on the neck. So that kind of pure supremacy in my gana, in my race, that anugraha will give. And it never goes, it never loses its value. And also, anabhagaminim tam maavah jatavedo rakshmi manabhagaminim yasyam hiranyam vindeyam gamasvam purushanaham. Please see, it's not like I get today these three qualities, four qualities. One is supremacy in my race, in my gana, with character. Purity like a cow and energy like a horse. And such a unparalleled character which can win over millions of relatives for me. Vasudhaika kutumbakam. the whole world's become my family. That kind of thing, let it be with me forever. Not just when I am reciting this Suktam. Forever, please invite. So, summing up these two verses, what you learned so far? I'm invoking that fire of knowledge in me and calling him Jataveda. Hey Jataveda, bring me that Lakshmi. Bring me that wealth, which is not a form. Money you can see in form. Gold you can see in form. This Lakshmi is formless Lakshmi. These are called Ananga Devatas. Ananga Kusuma, Ananga Mekhala, Ananga Madana, Ananga Madanatra, Ananga Rekha, Ananga Vegini, Ananga Ankusha, Ananga Malini. Ashta Lakshmis are Anangas. They are not seen. Removal of Ashta Pashas from me is called Ashta Lakshmis. So bring me that unseen Lakshmi. But through what? Through the golden aura who is coming to me with a golden aura when I close my eyes, golden image. Hiranyavarnam Harinim. By just meditating on that, it removes all my sinful thoughts. And also reminds me of the deer, which makes me feel that Chaitanya energy in me. And Chandram Hiranmayim Lakshmim Jataveda Maavaha. The moon, and which is connected to silver, let it control my mind and let me make egoless. The next line is, with whose grace I'm blessed with the supremacy in my race, the purity, the energy, and with unparalleled character, which can win over many relatives for me. So all this, let it be permanent with me. So once again, the second line, Tam Maavaha Jatavedo Lakshmi Manabhagamini Im Yasyam Hiranyam Vindeyam Gamasvam Purushanaham. Philippi, you're not reciting along with me. Kindly remove your hand so that I can see your lip movement. I'm watching everybody. That's why I asked you to switch on your video. I need to see the lip movement, right? Even if it is fault, that's fine. Ambal is there. Lastly, in the session, we'll say, Mantra Heenam Kriya Heenam. She's a mother. She'll bless us. So don't worry that you may recite wrong. Lakshmi will curse you. Don't have fear. Recite. Otherwise, you may not. It will be difficult. I will not say you may not get it. It will be difficult. Okay? Next. Ashvapurvam radhamadhyam hastinada prabhodinim. Ashvapurvam radhamadhyam hastinada prabhodinim. Ashvapurvam radhamadhyam hastinada prabhodinim. Ashvapurvam radhamadhyam hastinada prabhodinim. Sriyam Devi Mupahpaye Srirma Devir Jushatam. Sriyam Devi Mupahpaye Sriyam Devi Mupahpaye Sriyam Devi Mupahpaye Srirma Devir Jushatam. Srirma Devir Jushatam. Srirma Devir Jushatam. Sriyam Devi Mupapaye Srirma Devi Jushatam. Sriyam Devi Mupapaye Srirma Devi Jushatam. Sriyam Devi Mupapaye Srirma Devi Jushatam. Now, how I am seeing the Lakshmi invoked in me. He says, Lakshmi is coming. Ashvapurvam radhamadhyam hastinada prabhodinim. See, the beauty of Suktam, when you understand the inner meaning, wonderful meaning. How is she coming? Ashvapurvam. She's coming in a golden chariot. And that chariot is driven by horses. Can you guess what is the chariot? Ashvapurvam. Amma, you are the one who is like a horse, five horses, drawing this chariot of body, me. That five are five senses, indriyas. You are the indriyas for me. If you bless, the chariot will go in the Rujumarga. Otherwise, it may go here and there. It will also reach. Every chariot will reach the target one day. If not in this birth, some other birth. But, you know, delay. But if you bless, straight, shortcut. So, Ashvapurvam, I realize my indriyas I need to control. I need to get the blessings of my indriyas. When the indriyas are controlled with the help of Lakshmi, this chariot, this consciousness will go in the Rujumarga. Ashvapurvam Radhamadhyam. Radhamadhyam. See, he doesn't say Radham is in the back. Madhya means there is something else in the back, right? Every word is important. Ashvapurvam, Radhamadhyam, then who is in the back? That is God. That is the Paramatma. Jivatma, Radha. Paramatma, who is the driving force. But the Paramatma is also in form of Indriyas, in the Maya Swarupam. With the Paramatma blesses us, the same Indriyas will be striving to get the knowledge from the external world, from the internal body also. So the Ashvas can be used in both ways, for materialistic purpose and also for gaining knowledge, Indriyas. So, Ashvapurvam Radhamadhyam Hastinada Prabodhinim. Hastinada Prabodhinim. You know, these nadas are there. When I'm doing upasana, when we are doing upasana, we'll listen to certain nadas. And in our shastra, some nadas are considered to be auspicious nadas. That means when you listen to the nadas, certain nadis are invoked or are energized by the nada, and that will also control your character. So one of Chininadam, Chinichinadam, Veenanadam, Tantrinadam, Venunadam, Venunadam, Dakkanadam, Damananadam, Berinadam, Mrudanganadam, Prana Gosha. Different nadas are in that. Hastinadam is also one. Hastinadam means the ghinkaram was trumpeting sound of hasti, elephant. So then sound of elephant is compared with the anahar shabdam. So that is the driving force for all of us. So ashvapurvam, the indriyas, radhamadhyam, the body, hastinada prabhodinim, the God, the controlling power behind these two is always talking to you. Remember, talking, not murmuring. Hastinada prabhodinim. She's making mangala, auspicious sound. I am not able to listen because my mind is otherwise engaged. That's why Ananya Chintayantoma, Bhagavad Gita says, without thinking about anything, you should think about me. So, Ashvapurvam Radhamadhyam Hastinada Prabhodinim Sriyan Devi Upahvaye Srirma Devi Jushatam Upahvaye. I'm inviting that Lakshmi. Please come. Even though it says, please come, let us not misunderstand Lakshmi is going to come from California or some other place. Lakshmi is well within us. I'm only invoking that Lakshmi in me. So, Sriyandemim Upahvaye, Upahvaye, sit very close to me. That's where the Lakshana of Upadhi is mentioned. Upadhi is what? Suppose you take a prism and you take a hibiscus flower. This prism is white in color. But the hibiscus flower, the more closer and closer it goes to the prism also looks like red in color. It's called apadinchabarindi. Upadhi, because of that, that character, that vastu guna will be invoked in you. So I don't want Lakshmi to hang on to the walls of my puja room. I don't want Lakshmi to sit in the peetam of my puja room. I want the Lakshmi to come and sit close to me in my breath. Upahvaye. Come closer, come closer, come closer, come closer. You need to say, and close so that you, I can experience you in my breath. That is the closest point. So upahvaye means come and stay in my breath. Can you miss the breath? If Lakshmi is in the puja room, only certain times we do the puja room, puja. If Lakshmi is only in the sound, only certain time we recite the mantra. But I'm asking, hey Lakshmi, Jataveda, bring the Lakshmi so close to me. Upahvaye, upasana, upasana. Please come and sit close. You are not different from me. And I want Hamsa Tulika Talpa. In the 64 Upacharas, Hamsa Tulika Talpa. Hamsa Tulika Talpa. That means Hamsa Soham Soham Hamsa. Sit on the bed of the feathers of swan, which is compared to the breath. So, Upafaye Srirma Devi Jushatam. So, let the Lakshmi be in my breath and always bless me with these qualities. What are the four qualities? Gold, cow, horse, cow, and relatives. What is gold? Supremacy in my race, purity as of a cow, agility and chaitanya, live energy like a horse, and unparalleled role model like character which can win over the entire world for me, and that character the Lakshmi will give. So once again, this third stranja, naku 5 minutes unga cheppandi 7 ki.
Ashvapurvamradamadyam hastinada prabodhini. Ashvapurvamradamadyam hastinada prabodhinim. Sriyam devim upahvaye srirma devir jushatam. Sriyam devim upahvaye srirma devir jushatam. Kanso osmitam hiranyaprakaram adram jvalantim truptam tappayantim. Some people say kanso osmitam, some people say kanso osmitam. Either way is correct. Kanso osmitam hiranyaprakaram adram jvalantim truptam tappayantim.
In Suktam, one more thing you need to realize. Certain line, like in Rudram, you cannot break in between. You need to recite it one breath. That's also an exercise for your, you know, breathing exercise for you. So here, Kanso Ospitam Hiranyaprakaram Adram Jvalantim Truptam Tarpayantim. One stroke. Again. Kanso osmitam hiranyaprakaram adram jvalantim truptam tarpayantim. Padme sthitam padmavarnam tamihopahvaye sriyam. Padme sthitam padmavarnam tamihopahvaye sriyam.
Padme Sidam Padmavarnam Tamiho Pafaye Sriyam. I see most of the lips not moving. And I'm sorry to say, if you don't move your lips and recite along with me, two things are sure. Number one, you're not respecting my instructions. Number two, you're just listening like curiosity. I don't think there's a word like seriosity, but let us invent a new word, seriosity. Instead of curiosity, we want seriosity, right? So please, once again, recite along with me.
Kanso pitam miranya prakaram adram jvalantim truptam tarpayantim padme sitam padmavarnam tamiho pafaye sriyam.
Now, what are the qualities of Lakshmi? How I can invoke Lakshmi? Lakshmi is not a form. I need to realize Lakshmi in my... Lakshmi is a female or male? Anybody? Beyond gender, though she may appear to us for our mind as a male, female, my Guruji used to tell, he's a great, great thinker. And so very few people can match his thinking. Sometimes we used to wonder whether that thought makes any sense or not. Whenever young, 27 years, he used to say, when a cockroach becomes spiritual, what will that cockroach meditate on its God? A big cockroach, that's all. Because cockroach cannot think of any other thing other than a big cockroach. In the same way, he's not rationalistic, he's not an atheist. He loves murtis, he has got a beautiful temple, everything he constructed. But at the same time, you should not get stuck with that form. That's what he says. It's everything. So the cockroach becomes spiritual. It can think of big cockroach with power. So there are qualities in that. Even though he's gunatita, rupatita, namatita, bhavatita, tatvatita, atita, beyond everything. But how can I meditate on beyond everything? With this limited form, it's impossible almost. So I just bring that infinite thing to a finite thing. So when it is a finite thing, it acquires guna. So what are the qualities of Lakshmi?
Kanso smitam.
Every suktam, every prayer will say, for the ladies, particularly. Not only ladies, gents also.
Mandasmita prabhapura madhyat kame samanasa.
How you need to laugh. Just the tooth should be just barely visible, like a splashing star. The tooth, white tooth, should be visible. And the lips should be slightly widened. And that kind of slight smile will make the Shiva drown in that flow of beauty. Mandaspita prabhapura majjit kamesa manasa. All the ladies should smile because lady is a secret. Excuse me. Lady is Shakti, Maya. Jnana Surupam, Maya Surupam. If you approach her with the right bent of mind, she'll be the Jnana Surupam. If you approach her with a crooked mind, she'll be a Maya Surupam. All of you know that, right? We don't need to tell that. So, that lady is considered to be a secret. That's why Guhyam. And the smile is also a secret. Nobody knows what is behind the smile. So, Mandaspita Prabhapura, very light smile. Kanso Smitam. Hiranya Prakaram. Why she is living in a golden fort? Durga. anybody who enters the fort, why it is said fort means you are protected. Durga Durgama Chedini. Nobody can break that wall and come inside. So she is in a golden fort. Kansos Mitam Hirana Prakaram Ardram Jwalantim. Like I told before, Ardram Jwalati Jyotiramahatmi Jyoti Jwalati Brahmahamatmi Yohamatmi Brahmahamatmi. Same, Ardram Jwalati. She is Tejomaya Surupam. That means energetic, knowledgeable, fire-like strength. Everything is there. But at the same time, Karuna Surupani, Tejomayi, Karunamayi. Both are there. Ardram, Jwalantim, Truptam. Whatever you say. That's why Tamil is wrong. Edhaadu unnu panni tholayanda. Summa and the book verti in the book verti in the Kelvigate and the Kelvigate, ye alayringa. Edhaadu unnu pannungala. So do something, not just by external ritual, show some characteristic changes in you. Otherwise, we will be bringing defame to the entire system. People should not say, oh, that lady is doing so many pujas. Look at how she is behaving. That fellow is having so much Chaurasi mantram, but externally how he behaves. That's why we don't believe in the system. You are giving a chance to the other person also. So, Nitya Santoshini, Nitya Truptam, whatever little you do, whatever, what you call, Bindu Tarpana Santushta Purvaja Tripura Ambika, Nitya Truptam Animana Sahansika, Nitya Truptam first. So, whatever is there, you cannot please her. That is another thing. Whatever you do, you are only pleasing yourself to make yourself a Ananda Swarupa. But never think that you are trying to please God. Is already pleased. A complete saturated pleasure is there. She is only a giver, not a taker. We cannot give anything to her. We can only take from her. So in that way, Kanso Pitam Irinya Prakaram Ardram Jwalantim Truptam Tarpayantim. When we are doing Tarpana, we are saying, we are expressing our gratitude and happiness. Tarpayanti means anybody who approaches her, anybody who experiences her in his or her breath, he is also getting the bliss. So finally, what is Sri Suktam giving to us is not just wealth. Wealth will come. Definitely it will come. But more than wealth, it gives joy, pleasure. And many people ask me, what should we do to have courage in this difficult situation? We are all scared. I told already, there can be only fear and devotion. Bhayam, bhakti. Where there is devotion, there cannot be a fear. So trust in God, you'll be all right. So, Kansoho Pitamirinya Prakaram Adram Jvalantim Truptam Tarpayantim Padme Stitam Padmavarnam Tamiho Paffayestriyam. Certain flowers, certain animals, certain birds, certain beetles, they are also lucky. They took place in the suktas. They took place in the epics. They took part in all the stotras and we should also say like Lalita Sahasranamam, what is that? Khadgamala. Mitre Shamai, Shashti Shamai, Uddi Shamai, Charyanadamai, Lopa Mudramayi, Lopa Mudrachta, Leela Kripta Brahmanda Mandala. We should live a life like that. She is worshipped by Lopa Mudra. Lopa Mudra, Agastya's wife. Her name has taken place in Lalita Sahasranamam. And her verse has taken place in Veda. She's the only lady whose verse has taken place in Vedas also. So we should go to that kind of life. So it says, Kanso pitamarini prakaram adram vilantim triptam tarpayantim padme sitam. Padma is lotus. Where is the lotus coming from? Mud. Samsara panka nimmagna samudharana pandita. So when you enter that prakara, the fort, and meditate on the golden aura, the silver, the indriyas, the chariot, the one who controls the chariot, the sound of elephant, everything you meditate, you don't need to recite Sri Suktam completely. Just meditate on that part, little by little. Once you meditate, you come up from the mud of samsara like a lotus. On the lotus she is sitting. As long as you are in samsara, you will be with worms, coronas, Ebola, these viruses. This is in the samsara. But with courage, with strength, with confidence on her, you should come up. Whatever may be the situation will be like this. If today corona, tomorrow something else. But whatever comes, mere paas maa hai, that feeling should make you strong and face anything. Take care. Wash your hand. Somebody is having a mask also while reciting. I'm seeing him from the screen. Even there also they are having mask. That's fine. Good. Take care. But see that nothing will happen to India and any country where the spiritual beliefs are maintained. Any country. So, Padme Sitam Padma Varnam. Again, Padmam. Padma Varnam. Varna means the color. The color is seen by you. Similarly, the character is seen by you. So, when you come up from the mud of samsara, the exceptional character, Padma Varnam Tami Hopa Fayesriyam. Again, please bring that Lakshmi to me so that I can experience not just today, every moment. I breathe in and breathe out. See you tomorrow, 6 p.m. Sri Maatre Namaha.